TNA Wrestling, that stands for Total Nonstop Action. You going back in the ring?
Well, I'm heading over to Australia to wrestle at the end of November. I'm going to kind of check out the Hulk Hogan sea legs. And it's been a great career. And the fans have stuck behind me through thick and thin, and they've been loyal. And I just decided, you know, I had to get busy living or get busy dying, Larry. And I'm not exactly sure what I'm going to do, but I'm going to contribute as much as I can.
But
I'm going to try to take this business to a whole nother level.
You will wrestle in Australia?
Yes, sir. I'm wrestling in at the end of November in Australia.
All right. Lots of questions about wrestling being tweeted into our King's things. Here's one. What's the biggest difference between your heyday and wrestling now?
Well, I think probably the biggest difference is nobody told me how to wrestle. Nobody told me how to talk or think. You know, a lot of things have changed. You know, there's a lot of people behind the scenes that write scripts and basically tell the wrestlers how to walk and talk and basically try to tell them what to do in the ring. I think that's the basic difference between when I did my thing.
Another question, Hulk, why did you start using steroids? And assuming you have, why did you stop?
Well, I mean, at the time when I got in the professional wrestling business, not trying to point fingers, but everybody in all the sports industries were using them, baseball and football and hockey and wrestling. And at the time when I got in the business, the guys were huge, larger than life, and the steroids were legal at the time. But around 1988 or 1990, people got re-educated. They realized that it wasn't something that was necessary, especially for sports entertainment and exhibition like wrestling is. So people have been re-educated, thank God.
There are reports your son Nick has taken up wrestling training. True?
Well, I heard my son Nick, in his spare time, is heading out to North Hollywood to a gentleman named Rikishi's wrestling school and learning the ropes. So it's going to be interesting.
What do you think of that?
Well, I think he's curious at what his dad was attracted to all those years. He could be wanting to get in shape, and he could be just having fun, but it's going to be kind of interesting to see where that ends up.
Would you do another reality show?
Yes, sir, I would.
With Jennifer and your life now, you would do it again?
I don't know if it'd be with Jennifer and my life, but I would sure love to do a reality show where we tried to find the next Hulk Hogan and see if that guy's out there.
So it would be like a talent search.
Well, I could kind of see an American Idol.
Yeah.
An American Idol type show for wrestlers to find the next great Hulk Hogan. I think that'd be interesting.
Whoa. Hey, best of luck, Hulk. And I want to thank David Houston for assisting us on that key question. I'm very anxious that your book does well. Always good being with you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Hulk. Thank you, David.
Thank you.
And Hulk's book is My Life Outside the Ring. Jermaine Jackson is...